Thomas Young was born on June 13, 1773 in Lebanon, England. He was a scientist, researcher, physician, and polymath. He belonged to a Quaker family of New Verdon, Somerset, where he was an eldest of 10 children. He and his family didn't get close, since soon after his birth, he was brought up by his mother's father, Robert Davis, in Minehead, about 15 miles from New Verdon. His father is Thomas Young Sr., a cloth merchant and banker. Very soon, by the age of 2, Thomas was reading fluently. Before he was 4, he had read the Bible twice through. He also began memorizing poetry in both English and Latin, even though he could not yet understand Latin properly. Before he was 6, he was sent daily to a clergyman who had neither talent nor temper to teach anything well. He also attended a boarding school in Bristol for almost 18 months. He was supposed to learn arithmetic there, but found that he had got to the end of the textbook under his own steam before his master had reached the middle with the class. When he was almost 9, he entered a school in Crompton, Dorset, which was more suitable for a young genius like him, since students were given more freedom to progress at their own pace. By the time he left the school in 1786, he was knowledgeable in many languages and had also acquired a good grounding in Newtonian physics, studied optics, and made several instruments with the help of a tutor at the school. Then he spent 5 years to 1792 educating himself in mathematics, reading Euclid's Elements and the Works of Newton. He also read other scientific books, as well as books on history and languages. At the age of 14, he had learned 12 languages, including Ancient Greek, French, and Italian. In the autumn of 1792, he moved to London to begin his studies of medicine. He also enrolled as a pupil of St. Bartholomew's Hospital. Required to dissect an ox's eye, he began to develop a theory of accommodation for the eye. Consequently, he published his theories in Observations on Vision read to the Royal Society of London on May 30, 1793. A year later, he was elected a Fellow of the Royal Society. Young continued his medical training, entering the University of Edinburgh in 1794. After 1 year of study, he went to the University of Rockington, arriving there in October 1795. And after 2 years, he went to Emmanuel College, Cambridge. Although enrolled in the medical course, he did not study medicine at Cambridge. He worked on his own, learning more physics. After his graduation, he read the paper Salt and Light to the Royal Society in January 1800, and a further paper on the mechanism of the eye in November of the same year. The second paper contained further details of the process of accommodation of the eye and measured astigmatism for the first time. In 1801, he read another paper on the theory of light and colors to the Royal Society, and it was published in the following year. This paper put forward a theory of free color vision to explain how the eye could detect colors. Moreover, he was appointed professor of natural philosophy at the Royal Institution. In 2 years, he delivered 91 lectures. He resigned in the summer of 1803 in order to concentrate on building his medical practice. But before doing this, he did further important work on physics, reading experiments and calculations relative to physical optics to the Royal Society in November 1803. In this paper, he presented a wave theory of light, using it to explain interference patterns and describe how he had determined the wavelength of different colors of light using diffraction. Also in 1804, Young was made Foreign Secretary to the Royal Society of London, a post he filled for the rest of his life. After 3 years, in 1807, Young published a course of lectures on natural philosophy and the mechanical arts. It was a two-volume work based on the lectures he had given at the Royal Institution, but also contained papers he had not delivered during his lecture, together with an incredible catalogue of scientific literature from Greek times up to the date of writing. The book contained more experimental evidence to support the wave theory of light and a mechanics lecture dealing with elasticity, where Young's modulus is introduced for the first time. In 1811, he was appointed to St. George's Hospital. He carried out his duty there with great diligence, but failed to make much of an impression. In regard to his personal life, he married Eliza Maxwell in 1804. It was a happy marriage, but they had no children. In February 1829, he began to experiment difficulty in breathing and unfortunately passed away 3 months later. Thomas Young was a scientist who made tremendous contributions to physics. His most famous contribution is said to be Young's double slit experiment. It is a demonstration of the wave theory of light, which proposes that light behaves as a wave. The diagram below describes his experiment. When monochromatic light passing through two narrow slits, it illuminates a distant screen. A characteristic pattern of bright and dark fringes is observed. This interference pattern is caused by the superposition of overlapping light waves originating from the two slits. Young's double slit experiment also provides a method to measure wavelength. Another one is Young's modulus, a numerical constant that describes the elastic properties of a solid undergoing tension or compression in only one direction. It is sometimes referred to as the modulus of elasticity. Young's modulus is equal to the longitudinal stress divided by the strain. Stress and strain may be described as follows in the case of metal bar under tension. Young's modulus formula can also be written as E equal to sigma divided by epsilon. Well, have you ever wondered where the word energy has come from? It is Thomas Young who coined the very term energy in 1807 at his lectures on natural philosophy. Whoo, very impressive. Not only does he have great contributions to the physics field, he also has an honored place in physiology, philology, medicine, and music. Without any doubt, Thomas Young is truly fabulous. He is considered to be the last person to know everything, since he basically knows everything. He also wrote about various subjects in contemporary editions of the Encyclopedia Britannica. His learning was so prodigious in scope and breadth that he was popularly known as Phenomenon Young. Many scientists in general and physicists in specific also expressed their admiration and respect towards him and his works. That is all. Thanks for listening. And this is the bibliography.